of Ashura, and in the days of Muharram, days like this. And on the lands and on the soil of the land of Nainawa, or what is called Karbala, there were two forces in front of each other. Two kinds of human beings. One who sold their souls to Shaytan, sold their souls to the devil for shifa min ad-dunya, for a couple of dollars, or a cheap seat, a cheap kursi that will never last. Because no matter how big the kursi is, the chair and the position, you will die and the chair will be inherited by someone else. Ibn Kathir rahimahullah, al-Dimashqi al-Umawi, al-Hafiz, the student of Ibn Taymiyyah, he mentions in Al-Bidayah wa Nihayah, Khuruj al-Husayn, the exit or leaving al-Husayn, leaving al-Madina for seeking the leadership. And we obviously, we respect al-Hafiz ibn Kathir as a man, Allah bless him, rahimahullah. Lakin, excuse me, what kind of leadership does al-Husayn need to seek? Yani al-Husayn wants to seek a chair to sit on that Yazid sat on, a chair that is Yazid is sitting on, which is floating on a river of the blood of innocent Muslims, and a chair that is built from the skeleton and the bones of the Muslims. That's not a chair that honors al-Husayn. Al-Husayn has a chair in the heart of every mu'min till the day of judgment. Al-Husayn has a kursi in your heart if you are a believer. And Husaynun minni, this is a hadith of Sahih, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, Husaynun minni wa ana min Husayn. Husayn is from me and I am from Husayn. If you love Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you love Al-Husayn. It's automatic. Huh? Al-Imam Husayn's message is much bigger than peace. Much bigger than that. Al-Imam Hussein was there to revive the deen of Allah. And he left us this message that you need to be vigilant. He wanted to wake up the pride within you as a Muslim, that you should not live on your knees, that you should not take humiliation. He wanted to revive the consciousness that was sleeping in the people of the Ummah, that this is the deen of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Let no one else tell you otherwise. It's not about tears. We're not, if we shed a tear on Imam Hussein, we're not crying on him. He is shaheed. He is succeeding in the dunya and akhirah. We cry on our own state and hal, that we are so low, we're not learning from Imam Hussein's example. That's what we're crying about. And for those who try to marginalize Imam Hussein's message and dilute it, and they exert every effort and they bring all their shayateen from the jinn and from the ins, both, to help them suppress Imam al-Husayn and his message. I have only one hadith to tell you, that's sahih, fi Muslim, with Tirmidhi. I left you two things. If you hold on to them, you will never be misguided. The book and the itra. And the book mandates the sunnah, so you're not saying we're replacing the sunnah. No. Al-Qur'an mandates the sunnah and makes it obligatory. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ma ataakum ar-Rasul faqudhuh, wa ma nahakum anhu fantahu. So if you don't believe in the Qur'an, you don't believe in the sunnah. If you don't believe in the sunnah, you don't believe in the Qur'an. Al-Thiqalu al-A'zam is the book and the sunnah. Wa al-Thiqalu al-Akhar huwa itrati ahla bayti. You're trying to marginalize al-Husayn. You're marginalizing the deen. Because the deen is what Al-Husayn stood for. And he's the one we ought to hold on to, not simply abandon and dilute. For those Yazidi apologetics who think that the killed and the killer are the same, and the zalim and the mazloom are the same, and the thief and the one who was stolen from him is the same, and the raper and the rapist and the raped are the same, I got news for you. Islam came to ensure justice and equality, not to confer an official cover on all those tyrants and transgressors. Islam did not come to teach people to be humiliated. Islam did not come for people to be enslaved to their leaders and tyrants. But Islam came to free the most enslaved of slaves, to make the most enslaved of slaves masters, because they are for the sake of Allah. Islam came to tell people, all of you are slaves of Allah. No one is better than the other except by taqwa. That's the message of Islam. Change it as much as you want. Bring all you have and all your army and bring all the people who can write. Hire all the hired pens and hire all the papers and hire all the writers and all the TVs and everything that you want. Bani Umayyah were stronger, and Hussein will always irritate the sleep of those tyrants. He will irritate them until today. When they hear about Hussein, they still shake. They don't want the name of Hussein to come. Why? Because he's the voice of freedom and haqq. You know where to hold on to. I leave you with this. Hussein is a long way to understand.